Vero, and today we're gonna make Play-Doh. We're gonna make super awesome glitter Play-Doh. So the things you'll need are 2 packs of Kool-Aid or any food coloring. It could be powder, gels, or liquid. 2 cups of water, 1 cup of salt, 2 cups of flour, 1 tablespoon of cream of tartar, and 2 tablespoons vegetable oil and glitter. Or if you don't want to have glitter, you don't have it. And you want to mix it in the water so that it dilutes properly. And you put your 2 tablespoons of oil in. And you can mix the bubbles on top. They look awesome. Then you mix your dry ingredients in the pot. In the pot, you're going to be cooking it on the stove so that it doesn't, you don't need half your ingredients when you're putting them on the stove. So now you have to mix this. You just eyeball the glitter.
No, that's not good.
Yeah, we'll start with that. And if it doesn't make it very glittery, then we can just keep going. It's supposed to be good. There's no time to drink it.
That'd be gross.
Really? Oh, vegetable, yeah, because the vegetable oil. Okay, now I'm less tempted to drink it. And you pour this in.
Looking very glittery and pretty.
On the stove now. It's pretty sparkly. I added some more sparkles. This is how you want to set your oven. So you just put it on about medium. And once it's cooking, you want to keep stirring it. Since it's such a big pan, you want to do figure eight.
Yeah, it looks awesome!
That's scientist.
I always feel like I'm that scientist.
It's like practically done. It's when it's like that, like really. Yeah, I think it's done. Craziness.
I'm going to knead the dough. So, I'm making this dough for a Biscuits market, actually. And Biscuits is business camp. And we get to learn about running a business. Last year, I made Rice Krispies, and this year I decided to make Play-Doh. Both aren't too expensive to make, so it's good. So you really need to knead the dough. The way you knead dough is easier. If you start with the ball, then you push down with your palms, and you bring it back up. And then you sort of like twist it this way and push it. So basically you just push and fold and push and fold. And this way it gets all nice and creamy, it doesn't stick the consistency. Don't worry if it looks really bad when it comes off the stove. Like it has the color, but it looks like all grindy. Once you knead it, that will go away. Okay, so I'm done with the dough. So if you're not selling this or anything, you can just put it in a Ziploc bag or a container. And as long as it's sealed, it will stay good for, I don't know how long. Like weeks and weeks and weeks and weeks. And weeks and years and months and years. So probably like, not sure how many years and months and weeks and days I said. I know it lasts a long time. I've never counted time. And this, I used Kool-Aid. So it smells like orange. But if you don't use Kool-Aid, it probably won't smell like anything but like dough ingredients. So you can put scented oils probably in it. It smells different, so. You can also make white Play-Doh. And it's just the mixture without adding the coloring. And it looks like this, just nice snow white. I can show you some of the other colors I made. You can make every color you can imagine. fun to play with, sorry. And there you go, that's how you can make dough. I'd like to say thank you to Vero, who was here earlier. Make sure to watch when we did an experiment. That was really fun, and it was awesome. So, that's it for today. Like and subscribe. Bye! Oh, and an extra little review from Vero. Bye! Okay. Hey everybody, it's Emerald.
PowerPrinssess here. So I went to the big city.
So today we're going to be making these super cool recycled bottles.
To my town.
Bird feeders.
Thunder Bay.
This is how we're gonna make it, This is how you can make it.
I went shopping in the city. What did I get? What did I get? Let's see.
As you may know, I love making bracelets with the rainbow elastics, and I was running